Hi guys, my name is Mandeep, and in today's video we are going to discuss about big omega notation. In our previous video we have discussed about the big O notation, and in next video we will discuss about the big theta notation. So all these notations are asymptotic notations in data structure and algorithms. So let's get started with big omega notation. And again, following the tradition, first we will discuss about the theoretical part, what definition of big omega notations says. Then we will discuss one of the examples which will fit into that definition. So let's get started. Big omega notation states that let us assume that there is a function gn which is a non-negative function and which takes as a non-negative input as n. Fine. And if we have to find out the big omega of this gn, then it is a set of all the functions fn for which there exist two constants c and n naught such that f of n is always greater than c of gn for all the values of n which are greater than equal to n naught. Fine. So this is the definition of big omega notations. This is quite similar to the big O notations. The only difference lies over here is in big O notation, it was like this. For all the n which are greater than equal to n naught. The only difference lies over here. And this difference is that because big omega takes the lower bound and big O notation takes the upper bound, so difference lies over here only. Okay, so this is the definition, and let us move on to the example part of this. I will quickly show you an example, so which will fit into this definition. So again, let us assume that there is a function fn which denotes some time complexity, and again I am taking some hypothetical value, say 3n plus 2. And for this function, g of n will be n. So if we have to find out the big omega for these two expressions, then we have to put these values over here and find out the value of c and n. Again, I am reiterating, n naught is nothing, n naught is the value of n for which or after which the value of n, this statement holds true. Fine. So f of n in our case is 3n plus 2 is greater than c of gn. Gn is my n. Fine. So if I take n as 4, if you have to find the value of c and n, if then I am taking n as 1, then it will be like value of c will be 3n plus 2, 5, and value of n is 1, and this statement holds true. So 3n plus, if I am taking value of n is 1, then 3n plus 2 comes as 5, and this comes as, so value of c is less than equal to 5 and for value of n is equal to 1, this statement holds true. So this value can be taken as n naught. Fine. So all the values which are greater than all the value of n which are greater than 1, for these two expressions, if you have to fit this definition into this, then for all the values of n naught which is 1, the value of n which are greater than 1 will fit into this definition for these two expressions. So this is how big omega notation works. I hope you will find it useful. Please do like, comment, subscribe and share your feedback. Thanks for watching.